Hey everyone, this is Rino the Bouncer of the Codex. I got the privilege to play Assassin's Creed Odyssey demo, and I'm gonna go through multiple playthroughs as both Kassandra and Alexios. For the first time, we can play a full game as two protagonists, male and female. So here we go. So here we have the first demonstration of dialogue options. Apparently the game will feature a lot of those, allowing players to pick the path for their journey, which is something new for Assassin's Creed. Now we start gameplay. So, as someone who plays on PlayStation 4, the controls are going to be a bit of a challenge for me here, but I'll do my best. So, pardon me if I mess up too much. The interesting part is that Barnabas has two different eye types. So, is he blind in one eye, or is he a sage? The atmosphere is absolutely beautiful, and the engine is quite similar to Origins, but the visuals are much more improved. Let's check out the main menu. Displays only Odyssey quests about Hero's Journey. So these are the types of side quests, just like Origins had the exploration part and the tombs. The map of the game is expansive. It features so many islands: Misara, Efka, Anafi, Isaros, Terra. For now, we're going to be exploring Mykonos and Delos Islands. The rest will be left for the full game. The map looks actually larger than Origins, or at least about the same size. Here's the map legend showing different markers which may or may not be in the demo. Let's check them out. There are tombs, ship docks, caves, sanctuary, village, historical locations, legendary animals. Then apparently this is going to be something similar to the Curse of the Pharaohs, but that remains to be seen. That's just my assumption so far. And there are, of course, the viewpoints. As for the inventory, here's our new protagonist, Kassandra. You can change different parts of her character: the helmet, the gloves, breastplate, the belt, the boots, and the mount. Quite similar to Origins, except for no small list at the bottom where you can just upgrade stuff. You can apparently change everything. There are different engravings that you can add to your character, each one of them giving your character different abilities, kind of similar to The Witcher. The game is apparently emphasizing a lot on RPG elements, even much more than Origins, which is a wonderful thing. We can add a hood and a mercenary helmet. And here, mount. We have a spear, Spartan, javelin. So apparently Senu now is back, but under a different name called Icaros. Of course, it's not the same eagle as Senu, but there's the eagle vision is not is back in the same way Origins presented it to be, but not in the classic way, and it's through another eagle, the one we saw in the beginning. It's a welcome return, as most of us have actually enjoyed having a bird's eye view of everything. And we can still attack targets with Icarus. And now,
you trying to get killed?
Oh,
wonder if I could practice this test.
Get going! You're in the way!
I'm gonna try to finish this quest, but afterwards I'm gonna be doing more exploring and checking out the merchants and everything that I can stumble upon. As you can see, the HUDs and the gameplay is quite similar to Origins. Just for the record, Athena is a Greek goddess, and she's the equivalent of Minerva in Roman mythology. So this should be interesting, or I just hope the game will go as far as exploring that part, because we really have missed Minerva since Assassin's Creed 3.
Not long before.
Phobos is the horse's name.
Help now. No, he'd never help me.
The horses are faster than, noticeably faster than Assassin's Creed Origins.
Control!
This is an eradication event, similar to Origins, so...
Yeah.
Combat seems to be exactly the same as it was in Origins, so for those of us who enjoyed the combat in Origins and the change of style compared to other games, are really going to enjoy this one. Kassandra still has no shield, or perhaps she never will, I don't know yet, but so she cannot deflect that with shield because she doesn't have it.
That was a kid!
Set him on fire. So as you can see, the dialogue options don't always have meaningful outcomes. Sometimes there's just a change of attitude. Or sometimes it can just buy you time if you want to do another quest instead of continuing it right away. Actually, they were quite late to put me here. We only recorded 21 minutes.
Okay.
Yeah. So do we have more time? Because I only just recorded 20 minutes of it. Yeah. Yeah, please.
On your side. Thank you.
So here we can check out the character abilities. We have a similar skill tree to Assassin's Creed Origins, and you can grow your character in three different classes. Of course, you can grow them all together, and you can just focus on one until you can manage to get more skill points to grow the others. Very similar to Assassin's Creed Origins. Apparently here, the leap of faith can be learned. Same for whistling, knockout and recruiting, defensive maneuvers, man at arms, assassinations, Eyes of Icarus, meditation, which is going to be able to let you change day and night cycle, like Origins, and summon Phobos, which is the ability to call out for your horse. This demo has already unlocked these features, so, and they have a number under each one of them, so they're upgradable, and you can either raise your level to upgrade some, while others require you to get synchronization points. So apparently synchronizing viewpoints allow you to unlock new abilities. We can check out the other ones. So here you can take a look at how the abilities can be executed. Of course, I cannot unlock all of them right now because I don't have enough skill points, and I want to make sure I cover as much ground as you. Here they have the Spear of Leonidas artifact. What remains of the legendary Spear of Leonidas, its metal glistens with hidden potential. So apparently here we're talking about a first civilization artifact, which is the Spear of Leonidas being a weapon in the game, which is absolutely interesting because the game takes place before Origins, as I speculated on the Codex a few weeks back. And so the main weapon here is a first civilization object, so I wonder what will the game offer. In Assassin's Creed Unity, we had a first civilization weapon as a gameplay item, and it was a Sword of Eden. But here, we're yet to see what this weapon will be capable of, and if it's going to have any story context for its existence, or so I hope. Quest completed. Here we have like a hideout. And now you can fight Podrakus. The next quest.
I say we sell them and get in some mounts that can do their job.
That doesn't surprise me.
I'm not letting you out of my head.
So let's try. I'm gonna try to use Icarus to be able to cover as much ground as possible and show you the world of the game in detail, at least briefly. This is the other island, Delos. Let's find a boat. This is an early build. This is an early build for the game, so any glitches you see are not representative of the final product. We're about to leave Mykonos City and travel to Delos. Let's see. Naval combat seems to be similar to Assassin's Creed Origins with Aya.
The gods won't favor us for killing innocents, Commander!
And the sea shanties are back.
We wait for the commander's return, Commander.
Sailing is a lot more seamless than Origins and even Black Flag. You can sail your ship faster, and combat is much easier than it was in Black Flag. And the transition between land-based exploration and sea-based traversal is much more seamless than before. So we can call Icarus even when we are sailing a ship, which is wonderful because it allows for an even more seamless way to know your directions or know your objectives. There are two quests there on the other island, and this is actually pretty amazing. If we check the game map again, we can tell that there are these two islands there outside of the demos area. So let's go explore Delos. You can sail normally and you can sail faster.
I don't think they can pull the oars any faster! Watch for the shallows! Commander away! No further orders!
I managed to have a conversation with the dev team of Assassin's Creed Odyssey. The game will be featuring romance options for each character. The entire games are playable as Alexios or Kassandra, and you can have the same experience as either character. The game emphasizes a lot on having your own Odyssey, that you control everything and that the story you explore is your own story. For example, and you might wonder how this works with the anime synchronization. The idea here is to have full control of your own destiny, and that the experience you have in the anime is, even if it's going to be different from others because of their choices, it's still going to be the right one because you are making the decisions, just like in real life when you have, like, you have to make a choice about something and this is the right path. The other possibilities do not exist because you did not take them. So in sense of the Animus, when the present day character is reliving the memories, they are living the same experience, they are living the correct experience according to your own journey. So it's your own independent odyssey. Let's try and see if there are any special markers to explore. Shrine of Heracles, Sanctuary of Apollo. I want to see if we can come across any tombs. There's a main quest here. Let's see if we can make it to one of the legendary animal dens or the tombs. This is a regular animal den, not a legendary one. Which is understandable for a demo, not to include everything. Perhaps it's stuff that you would unlock later, or perhaps even part of DLC or something. I don't have any official confirmation of that yet. Okay. So now I'm going to be trying to show you Alexios. Now I know your impressions. Alexios sounds a lot like Ezio, which means our fan favorite is partially back. Whoa, this looks like a really big battle. Kind of similar like how Connor Kenway was able to get into battles in Assassin's Creed 3. But there is a real war going here, and it's kind of like the den defenses meet Assassin's Creed 3 battles, which is really cool. Apparently you can pick which side you would fight for. Oh, not really. I mean, our side is the Spartans here, so we're fighting against the other side. Menu for Alexios. This is our protagonist. Can also use a helmet here or the hood. So it's mainly similar. Icarus, you can call it Icarus even when you're on a mount or whether you're sailing. It's great. Okay, so similarly to The Witcher, if you steal items, like when you usually loot in Assassin's Creed games, there are no consequences. But here, there will be consequences. People will notice you and they will react to you. So beware when you're about to take something that isn't yours. Synchronize our first viewpoint. So upon synchronizing viewpoints, let's explore this tavern here. Message board. This is a message board here. So similarly to The Witcher, we're able to. There are message boards in the game where you can find side quests on. Once you check it, it will be added to your list. Yes, treasure chests are back, just like Origins, and now let's try and check out that tavern. Thank you. can only do a handful of things with this demo, so because of time constraints, so I'm trying to show you as much as possible as both characters. Speaking of blending in, like Origins, Assassin's Creed Odyssey does not feature any form of social stealth. Which is understandable because there are no assassins yet, like, at least not in the way Bayek is supposed to found them, supposed to establish them as. They're like, whoa, these are some cool new moves. Swimming is quite easy and seamless, and it includes many. It's kind of like a mixture between Assassin's Creed Origins. It's actually a lot like Assassin's Creed Origins because. And the city itself having so much water, you can just swim up and down above and beneath anything. You can like go to submerged areas within the city or swim in an open area like the waters. Naval is included in the game, but you can also sail your own small boat. Just like you would in Assassin's Creed Origin. So to explore smaller areas or cross smaller distances, you don't need to take your own ship. You can just take any boat and just sail away. Icarus is also accessible from small boats, not just main ships, which is wonderful. Here we can upgrade. You can. Alexios just managed to find another bow, so we can change the bow now. These are quest items. You can sell and salvage money for weapons. Okay, so when you lower the Delos Islands nation power, you will weaken the guards of Podrakus. So there is some connectivity between what you do in the game, like burning war supplies or doing different tasks will make you here. You can find burning war supplies, finding Enigmata Ostraca, loot the treasure. There are tasks you can do, but burning war supplies will weaken the enemy. Which is a great way. It's an impressive way to and a very new one to the franchise that you would be able to weaken your enemy not only by just raising your level but also by destroying supplies, doing stuff that you would realistically do that for assassins to realistically do to weaken their enemy. Yeah, I'm sure Chris can use some combat with the spear.
Enjoy this! Keep eyes on them!
Because the spear is a first civilization artifact, it can execute these powerful moves like knocking off enemies. And you can heal yourself. Apparently the Spartan kick that you can see in the trailer can be used here. And I died. Building up adrenaline this time will allow you to use these abilities, so Baya could execute a special attack, only one, when he builds his adrenaline meter, but here you can do a multitude of four that you can map to your wheel.
Ah, I see him! He's got to slow down sometime. I'm on your train!
New heat show up again!
Ready! Don't worry, this won't take long. This is almost boring.
Let's get the hell out of here.
Victory!
Won't last much longer.
That's how you unassign an ability, so you can put another in its place. Let's take out this. This is to break a shield. This is the special Ring of Chaos on surrounding enemies. And that's how you reassign it to the wheel. Rush Assassin. This is similar to the Animus Pulse. You can. Okay. apparently you can quick save in a specific at any point in the game, which is new to the franchise. So I think now it's time to wrap up our demo, and thank you for watching, and Assassin's Creed. It's time we wrap up our demo, so thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the gameplay.